This is a first video in a series of exercises exploring the if statement. We'll use the if statement to set conditions when to run parts of the code and when to skip. Hey, my name is Victor Stepanoff, and I'll be guiding you through this beginner Blender Python exercise. Today, we'll be taking our first look at if flow control statements. The if statement will allow us to control what parts of the code are executed and what parts are skipped. This will be done based on the conditions that we set. Before we dive into Blender, I want to show you a number of slides just to get on the same page. Here's an example of how an if statement looks. It has a number of main parts. The first thing that you gotta notice is the if statement keyword right here. This tells Python that what's coming next is an if statement. Then we have a Boolean expression, and then the body of the if statement, meaning that the code that's going to be executed if the Boolean expression is true. Boolean expression is an expression that values to true or false. For example, is 5 less than 10? That is true, so that'll evaluate to true. And the next expression is 1 greater than 2? That's not true, so it's going to be evaluated to false. In Python, to represent the result of a Boolean expression, we have the Boolean data type, and that data type could only be true or false. Let's jump into Blender to see how this works in practice. All right, once we're in Blender, let's go into the scripting workspace and then hit new to create a new script. Next, the very first thing that we need to do is import BPY. This will allow Python access to Blender's functionality. I'm going to just copy a comment for us to just reference here. You can type it out if you want. So the very first thing let's do is just clear the scene by hitting A, X, and then a delete. For this exercise, I'll be working with a cube and an icosphere. So let's add that by hovering over the 3D viewport and hitting Shift A, and then selecting icosphere, and then do the same thing again. So Shift A, and then select a cube. So I'm just going to copy these two commands right here from the info panel down below. Just copy like so, paste them in. I'm going to select all the parameters that are passing in, just delete them because we don't really need any of those today. Right. So I'm going to switch places. So I'll set the cube first. I'm probably going to set the cube size a bit smaller. Let's see, let's go with 1.5. Just want to see the ICO as well. If we just place it over, okay, you can kind of see that there's a cube and an icosphere if we set the size of the cube to 1.5. All right, so let's clear the scene, and if we run the script, right, we get the icosphere and the cube in the scene, right? So currently the flow of this script is that we first import BPY, right? We then create a cube, and then next we create an icosphere. All right, so let's create our first if statement. I'm gonna add a if statement right here. So I'm gonna use the if keyword. Then I'm gonna use, instead of creating a Boolean expression, I'll just use a Boolean data type right away without writing any fancy Boolean expression. So it's going to be true, and I'm going to indent it by hitting tab. There's a tab here, right? And then let's select everything, delete, and then run the script again. And as you can see, nothing really changed because this is evaluating to true, meaning that anything in the body of the if statement will be executed. Now let's switch this from true to false, meaning that this Boolean expression is going to evaluate to false right here. Right, I'm going to delete everything by hitting AX and then delete. Let's run the script again, and now you can see there's only an icosphere here. So if I hit G on the keyboard and just move this around, you can see there is no cube. Now let's take a look at how we can organize the code in a way that either an icosphere will appear in the scene or a cube. So Right now, if I make this expression true again, and delete everything and run the script again, we're always gonna have an icosphere or a cube, but I only want one of them to appear in the scene. So maybe I can just copy this if statement right here. And for example, I wanna have the cube the only thing appearing in the scene. So I'll create another if statement right here, set this to false, delete everything, run the script again. And now you can see that we have a cube. Let's now switch that and say, okay, you know what? I want to only have an icosphere appear in the scene, right? Then I'll just switch around those true and false and run it again. Now we only have an icosphere. So there's a way for us to provide an alternative when this statement is false, right? So if this is false, right, we're just skipping this part, but we can also use the else keyword. So else, this means that if this part is false, then execute this other piece of code. So let's do that. So I'm going to delete everything, run it again. And now you can see, instead of having another if statement, we're just using that else keyword, meaning that if this is true, execute this part. If this is false, execute this, right? So let's change this to true, delete everything, and run it again. And as you can see, you can kind of switch in between true and false this way. Okay, now let's start looking at creating our own Boolean expressions. And we'll do that with some comparison operators. Let's take a look at the possibilities. These are the main relational operators that you can use in Python. It's greater than or equal to, not equal to. Let's take a look at how this works in the interactive Python console. So I'm gonna just create an Boolean expression, and I'm gonna say is 1 greater than 2. And so this is a Boolean expression, and when I hit enter, Python's gonna tell me if that's true or not true, right? So that is false. Again, we can also say is 5 not equal to 10, for example, and that is true, right? It's not. Is 5 not equal to 5? And that's false, right? So you can start constructing these Boolean expressions using the syntax right here. So let's just do that. Let's, instead of saying true, let's say that is 2 greater than 3. So let's delete everything from the scene and run the script. So you can kind of maybe pause the video here and try to figure out like what is going to appear in the scene. All right, we're going to get an icosphere. And because this thing, this expression right here evaluated to false. This is probably the first and last time you'll see anyone write a Boolean expression like this, because this will always be false, right? It's never going to be true. And there isn't really a good reason that we'll ever want to do this. So usually we would create some variables like foo and then bar and then use them, and then somewhere in the code for some other logic we'll change these, and then maybe it's in a for loop or some other way we're going to determine a new value for one of these variables. So usually we would use them in this way. So let's just do that. So maybe let's change foo to 5. So this is going to be true, and we're going to get a cube. And if you're learning something new, make sure to give this video a like. This will help me tremendously. All right, another Boolean expression could be created by using just a number. For example, if we just put foo here, right, or just even like 1, this will evaluate to true. So anything that is not 0 is always going to be true. So let's run that, and as you can see, the 1 is the true. Again, this could be 5. For example, we can use foo. This is also true. And behind the scenes, Python is actually doing this. So let's go into Interactive Python Console. And there's a special function like this that will return a Boolean. So for example, I can use one and that will be true. So this is what Python is doing behind the scenes right here. So we can do minus, right? So it's also true. The only time this will be a number will be false is when it's zero, right? Or for example, 0.0. But as soon as it's something that is not zero, like for example, 0.01, as you can see, this will always evaluate to true. I encourage you to play around with different values in the Python Interactive Console to see the results. Knowing that we can use numbers for Boolean expressions, let's generate some random numbers and see what that gives us. So I'm going to go up here and I'm just going to import random. And random is a Python module that extends Python's functionality to generate random numbers. And we're going to be using the rand int functionality. And you could, let's actually do this in the Interactive Python Console. I'm going to import random. And remember, to get some documentation about a particular function, you can just open a parenthesis and hit tab, and that will give you some documentation about what this function will be doing. So in this case, it's going to be returning a random integer from between A and B. So let's just do that. So I'm going to set 0 and 1. And if I just keep running this particular function, right, I'm hitting the up arrow and then hitting enter, right, up arrow and enter. And you can see that it's providing me different values. So let's just copy over this part right here, paste it here, and delete everything from the scene, and let's run the script. And you can actually see that we can try it again. And first time it was an icosphere, now it's a cube. Let's delete that and run it again. Again, an icosphere, again, a cube, again, an icosphere. So again, a cube. Well, you get the picture that, and again, a cube. So it will randomly add a cube or an icosphere into the scene. Okay, now let's do a couple of exercises to solidify your knowledge. And for the first exercise, I want you to create a Boolean expression that checks if foo is equal to 5. And if foo is equal to 5, it should we should add a monkey into the scene. And if it is false, then we should add a torus. So pause the video now and try it on your own, and then unpause it and I'll show you how I would have done it. All right, I hope you succeeded in that exercise, and let's just update this code right here. I'm gonna select foo and I'm gonna test for equality. Remember this equal to operator, so it's equal to 5. And to add the monkey, let's delete everything from the scene and add a monkey, and then add a torus. Let's copy these two commands right here. Let's delete everything from these parameters, right? So a monkey when it's true, and then a torus when it's false. So let's just do that. All right, let's run this code. So as you can see, foo is equal to 5 and we're adding a monkey. And when we maybe set it to 55, this will add a torus. All right, for your second exercise, I want you to generate a random number between 0 and 10. And if that random number is greater or equal to 5, I want you to add a cone. And if it's not, I want you to add a UV sphere. So pause the video now and try this on your own, and then unpause it and I'll show you how I would do it. All right, I hope you managed to solve that, and let's see how I would do, how I would have done it. So I'm gonna select everything and delete. Let's get a cone, and let's get a UV sphere. Right, let's go to the bottom of the info panel and just copy these two commands. Just do that again, just remove all the parameters. We don't need them today. So a cone is when it's true. And a UV sphere is when this is false. So we can just take this random int. This could be done a couple ways. We could use the random and write in here, but I'm gonna use variable foo. So from 0 to 10, and if foo is greater or equal to 5, we'll be adding a cone. Let's delete and run the script. All right, I'm just gonna run the script a couple more times until I get a UV sphere, and it's right the next thing that gets generated. Let's run it a couple more times. And you can see that it's randomly selecting either a cone or a sphere based on our expression right here. All right, if you feel a bit overwhelmed by this topic, that's okay. That means that you're on the verge of learning something new. From now on, I'll be trying to incorporate the if statement in the different exercises for beginners, so you can start building patterns and use cases of where you could use an if statement. I have a number of videos planned on the if statement going forward, so make sure to subscribe to see them. And thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.